So when I think about flare in someone with rheumatoid arthritis, I think about increased inflammation and increased disease activity, which means if you live with a chronic disease, there's a baseline that you are very comfortable living with. You may have symptoms that you know how to deal with on a daily basis. Flare indicates that those symptoms are getting worse and that you are experiencing more expression of the disease. Flare is also very interesting in how, as physicians, I look at the symptoms of flare or how a patient with rheumatoid arthritis may experience the symptoms of flare. An example of that is when you come to my clinic and you say, "Dr. Huck, I'm having a flare." I'm thinking about swollen, painful joints. But there's a lot more that you as a patient may be experiencing. We now know through research with our patient research partners that patients are often struggling with increased fatigue, increased stiffness in their joints. They may not be sleeping well. They may actually be very emotional about the symptoms that they are dealing with. They may find it very difficult to do things that they could easily do before. For example, preparing a meal may be different during a flare than when you're not in a flare. So flare is definitely an increased expression of your disease or increased activity of your disease. But as rheumatologists, we are trying to better understand what all it encompasses. The other thing that's important to remember is that not every flare is going to be exactly the same. Our patients can experience flare across a spectrum from very mild to very severe. Mild may mean that they have increased stiffness, a little bit of fatigue, but they can self-manage that. A very severe flare may involve several painful, swollen joints, severe fatigue, flu-like symptoms, and really a person who cannot live the life that they were living before this flare. And for a severe flare, we often have to intervene with a medication, whereas for mild flares, patients can often self-manage it. I think it may be hard for patients to predict when a mild flare will go on to become a more severe flare, and at what time should they reach out to their rheumatologist. I would say at any point where you are uncomfortable with a flare, it is absolutely reasonable to reach out to your rheumatologist, because part of what we want to do is to help you not only manage your flares, but also to educate you about how to deal with living with this chronic disease.